In Jesus' name. Even pastor talk to you, don't do this. Even your sister, your wife, you don't do this. You do it. You put into trouble. Now, you beg. Now, you cry. Whose fault? The pain, you are going to feel it by your own self. But not the one you are telling it. He can pet you, oh, I'm sorry, cry with you, but the pain is still with you. Amen? Is it not true? So why are you doing what you are doing? What is your intention? Why you are not coming to church early? Why you didn't come in the church? Or sometimes you come, not to come, or sometimes alternate. Why? What is your intention? What is your motive? Is it not enough transport? Or you don't have transport? Or you want to relax for yourself? Or you want to be with your wife alone? What is your motive? Why you don't want to be with the children of God? Why you don't want to worship with us? Why you don't want to worship God on Sunday? Why? Why you follow the man you want to marry? Or why you woman looking for man in the internet? What is your intention? Why are you looking in the WeChat or any social media? What are you looking at there? Is it not man? Is it not woman? What is your intention there? Are you going to marry that one? You are married man and then you're looking for inside the social media. What is your intention there? What do you want there? Why are you asking question in our faith clinic? What is your intention? To impress people? To impress your brethren? Or that you know a lot? That you know everything? What is your intention? Everyone has intention. And your intention, God noted it. Amen? God examined it. God searched your hearts. Amen? He weighed. Why are you saying what you are saying? Why are you telling the truth? Sorry. Why? To put to shame your sister, isn't it? Not because you want to tell the truth. You want her to put to shame, or you want him to put to shame. That's why you tell the truth of everybody. To embarrass him, to put him down. Not to rebuke him, not to tell the truth because you love her. No, you have your motive. Everyone is doing that and it's known to you, all those kinds of intention. Amen? Amen? Do you know? Everyone here knows what they are doing and you know what you are doing. Amen? Amen. Why are you cheating in the school? You want to pass but you didn't study. Is it right? Wow. Is it right, students? You want to cheat. You didn't study and you want to pass. It's not possible. Isn't it?
Yes.
Why you want to lie? So that you will not get punishment. Isn't it? Or you will not be ashamed. Why did you do that? Why you lie? Why you lie against me? Why are you doing this to me? What's my offense? What is your intention? What is your motive? Why do you do this? What makes you do that? And why you have heart to do that? And why are you crying to God? Are you crying to God because you see your fault? Or you asking for forgiveness? Why are you crying to God for healing? Because you want that your sickness to go and serve Him or do something for God? Is that your motive? Let our motive be pure. Amen? Amen. It is only two I give you in the Bible that those David and Jesus Christ, they are following because of food. That David, he put Uriah in the front so that he will die. And you, all that are sitting in front of me, I don't know your heart, but God knows every heart, every motives, all your, even your, what you are thinking, God knows it. Who is this talking in front of me? Yes, I am the servant of God. I'm telling you what God has told me to tell you. Amen?
Amen.
Let your motive or intention be
pure.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's go to Philippians 4:8. I am concluding, and God will help us. Philippians 4:8. And can somebody read also Psalms 139:23?
Philippians 4:8. Finally, brothers and sisters, whoever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things.
Amen. That is the one. Your motive, think on this thing, the truth. Amen? 4:8. Finally, brethren, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is of good repute, if there is any excellence and if anything worthy of praise, dwell on these things. Amen?
Amen.
These are, we are going to think on these things. Amen? Amen? Pure, love, honorable, right, lovely, repute. This is the one that God wants us to think towards other people. Amen?
Amen?
Not to pull down other people. We need to build one another, not to pull down one another. Amen?
Amen.
We are here to help one another. Are we here to fight? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's go to Psalms 139 verse 23. Praise the Lord. 139:23. I really want you to search your heart, because God knows you more than you know yourself. Because He's the one who manufactured you. He's the one who everything created you. You don't see your intestine, but God sees everything. You are like an X-ray. God sees you inside out. Amen?
Amen.
So everything we need to ask God, that God will search us. What is our motive? Why are we doing ushering? Why are we doing evangelism? Why are we doing children's ministry? Why are we doing all these things? Why we are not in the? We are not involved in the ministry. Why? Why are we always coming late? Why? You're tired of your work, isn't it? What is your motive? Your house is far. All has the reason. But if your reason is God is going to examine it, God is going to weigh it. Is it this one will pass? Or this one will not pass. It's up to God. It's up to me. Amen?
Amen?
It is God. I'm just telling what God wants me to tell you. Amen?
Amen.
Conclusion. Ecclesiastes 12:13-14. I want to conclude from there. I have finally got another finally. Are you there? Ecclesiastes 12:13-14.
Now all has been heard. Here is the conclusion of the matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the duty of all mankind. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every hidden thing, whether it is good or evil.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So the conclusion of all this matter that we are doing, our intention, our motive is to fear God and keep his commandments, because this is applies to every person. For God will bring every act to judgment. Everything which is hidden, whether it is good or evil. Amen? So all this action we are doing and thinking, our hearts is not pure, our hearts is not right to your friends, to you, to anyone, to your husband, to anyone. God will judge. Amen? Not pastor will judge you. It is God itself to judge you individually. Amen? So everyone must be pure in your intention, must be pure in heart. Now let us all rise up and search yourself. God sees you. I do not know your heart. I do not know your intention. God knows everyone's heart in this arena. So open your mouth and talk to your God. As we have sung the song, that the Holy Spirit is here. He is here right now. And tell yourself, you have lied, you have cheated, you have your intention to pull down one another, to fight or to do something, to put your brother or your sister into trouble. What is your motive? Talk to your God. Is it your heart pure? Is it your motive doing, telling the truth is pure? What are you telling God? Open your heart to the Lord. He said, open your mouth and God will going to feel it. God is willing to forgive you. He doesn't want anyone to be perished. He wants God to forgive you. Why are you not in the ministry? What is your motive? You don't want responsibility? Or you don't want, but you want protection from God. But you want the grace of God. But you want God to forgive you of your sin. What is your intention? Why are you doing what you are doing? Why are you saying what you are saying? What makes you do that? What makes your heart to create hatred towards your brother or your sister? Why you are keeping malice to your brother or your sister? Who will benefit? Is it you're going to profit all these things, your intention that is not good? No one. Let us ask God for the forgiveness. He says in 1 John 1, 9 that if you ask forgiveness, he's just and righteous to cleanse us and to all our unrighteousness. Let us ask God for the forgiveness. Let us ask God. Open your mouth. The Lord is waiting for you. If you have been doing what you're doing and it's not right into the sight of God, God is seeing you. God is looking at your heart. Search your heart. Be pure. God wants you to keep his commandment and fear him, because he will judge at the end of all your action. He is only the one who can forgive. He is only the one who can hear you. Your friends, your husband, your wife, your children cannot forgive you. Only Jesus Christ can forgive of all your sins. He knows you. He knows your deeds, all your action. Why your motive, why your intention is not pure? Why? Let our motive be pure. Let our thinking be pure every time. Lord, we just want to say thank you, God, for hearing us. Lord, I pray thee, forgive all our sins, oh God. All the bad motives, all the impure motives, all those uncleanness in our hearts, in our mind, in our action. Lord, forgive us. Cleanse us, oh God, from thy precious blood. We want to say thank you, God, for the forgiveness, because you have promised that if we ask forgiveness, you are just and righteous to forgive us. Thank you so much, oh God, for your people has confessed, oh God. There is freedom in confession. The truth shall set you free. Anyone who confess his sin shall have mercy. Have mercy on us, oh Father God. Thank you so much, oh Father. Lord, we just want to say thank you. God wants us purity in our hearts. Blessed are those who are pure in heart, for they shall see God. Let your hearts be pure so that you will see your Creator. We thank you so much, oh God, for this moment. We worship you. Let us sing, we give you glory. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord!